It's time to cowboy up here at Eldora. Boy, Buddy Kofoy gets aggressive right on the start there, nearly three wide. Look at Baston coming from the top rope. He's side by side with his CB Industries teammate. They race for the lead. It's Windham, Baston side by side. Thorson still down low.
And Baston goes right down the middle, as you said, Tony. That one got your breath. There's Baston down working the high side. Chris Windham fresh off that $20,000 win.
Tyler Courtney loses a spot to your championship point leader, Michael Buddy Kofoy. That'll put Sunshine back to the sixth position as he continues to fall under attack. Meanwhile, Tanner Thorson gets a good run of steam, but he's going to have to play defense here quickly against your championship point leader, Kofoy, rallying up around the top. That's exactly where our two leaders run, Windham and Baston, right up on the wall.
And there he goes down to the bottom. Let's see if Logan Stevie can slide into the fourth position. Maybe not there. Thorson wants to make something happen on the bottom, but Seavey's elbows up.
Logan Seavey going right after the point leader, Michael Buddy Kofoy. Those two youngsters from California rally right up against the wall. Tanner Thorson starting to move up and up the racetrack a little bit there in turns one and two. Windham is losing his
lead
to Spencer Baston. Baston cuts it from 6/10 down to 5/10. So Kofoy knows he's got pressure from behind. Now Seavey pulls right up alongside, down the back straightaway. The Tom Malloy driver will bury it down in turns three and four. Kofoy rips around the top. Boy, Seavey's built his momentum. Now he'll go top shelf on Kofoy.
How about that? He just decided to go right up there and see if he can run downhill and take that position from Buddy Kofoy, and that is tight sledding.
Logan Seavey makes that number 25 get after it. The 67 of Kofoy can do nothing but watch Logan Seavey drive away. That's a change for the third position. Seavey now on the podium. Baston looks like he's getting closer.
He is absolutely getting closer. Catching him is one thing, passing another.
Wow.
And he's got great momentum off of two.
Spencer Baston finds something that he hasn't had all race long, and that is speed, speeding up to get around Chris Windham. Baston right in his CB Industries teammates' tire tracks. They come across the line, three to go, and it's a three-car race for the win.
Yeah, Stevie's right there in the mix, and this traffic right now heading into turn number three is going to be a factor.
One up against the wall, that's Baston.
Yep.
Baston bounces off the wall as they came out of turn number two. So that gives Windham a little bit of breathing room. So Kofoy and Stevie start sliding each other for second position.
Unbelievable. Logan Stevie has absolutely put his spurs to it. But is the hourglass run dry?
Same story, different car. A NOS Energy Drink sponsored machine up front. And the Tom Malloy Trent Shoring number 25 of Logan Seavey is left to pursue. White flag in the air. Seavey's car chief, Jerome Rodella, told me last night if there would have been a yellow flag in that feature, it might have been a different result. Seavey's not going to have the benefit of a yellow flag. He's only got half a lap to do it. Down into three. Chris Windham, he went back-to-back at Houston's. Three wins in a row as he picks up the four crown here with the NOS Energy Drink National Midget.